I can put it on YouTube. And I'm using Windows, so this is actually going to be a little bit annoying. But when I try to record from my Mac, the GPU just can't keep up. I don't even have Telnet on the thing, so it's actually literally going to be easier if I just use my AWS. I guess it's just you and I for now. Just watch me find the flag and type it before I do. Oh, fuck. And I closed all my pages. See what kind of viruses are in here. All right, I'm probably gonna start with the easy ones at least. Okay, I actually suck at this kind of stuff. Is there a wgettable link somewhere? Ugh. I don't think that's gonna work. Yeah. I'm just going to transfer the files over to my Linux machine because I don't have anything better right now. Finally, my transfer is a little slow. Ooh, that could be cool. Okay, I could open that one in a hex editor, see if it has embedded zip files, which is exactly what I expect. Okay, so I'll take a look at this one because I honestly don't know what to do with just normal fucked up JPEGs. So this is JGIF. I have no idea what that is. So maybe just some bad bytes. FDD8. So that would be one bit wrong. FFD8 and end with FFD9. Okay, that was easy. So it was just one byte incorrect in the magic number. Fuck. I'm really not used to Windows. Boom! Oh, and I fucking chose the wrong username this time. So I'm playing against myself. Alright, that was the 20 point challenge. That means the 10 points gotta be easy. So let's open it back up in here. Okay, so if you go back to the magic number, it was supposed to be FFD8, FFD8, and end with FFD9, FFD9. J5. Okay, I'm literally out of ideas here. I know I could check like the like extra bits and some random color channel and stuff like that, but it's not my style. Okay, raw.dd. This is a boot sector. Okay, so hopefully I can just mount the second partition. I hope the global partition table actually doesn't matter. And then if I can do that, I can just explore it. So, blah, blah, blah. Wow, this website's shitty. Okay, mount. All right, now the offset is taking the site is garbage. Look at that. Okay, 32, 56. That's 63 times 5, 12. So I want 41, 6, 4, 8. It's gonna be somewhere there. Okay. Fuck. Okay, so that's gonna be it. But I have to SCP it back to look at it because I don't have a GUI on this thing. You know, a little bit easier. Now, if someone were watching this, he could just find my IP address and steal the flag from me. And this is the problem with a tiny instance. 172.312.851. I should see get requests here. It's not the public IP, that's the problem. There you go, another flag. UMDC sec degus or failure. Oh fuck, I put it in the wrong field. What was this? This is for 35. Alright, on to the next one. Okay, so it opens fine. I will have to open it up on my local machine. So why does it say it's a PNG? So it could be, see if there's a PNG header somewhere in there. Or wait, is there an offset already told? So at that decimal. So what I can do is hopefully extract it. So I can go ddif equals tux, of equals png.png, skip equals 5447. Oh, one, two, six, two, five, minus 5447. Decent. I saw a stream, Ginvel's stream, where he basically has a script that'll just quickly do image to text, so he doesn't have to do this crappy stuff. And I really should get that set up. Oh, and again, I forgot the point value. Okay, point value is 50. Fuck. There you go. Yeah, I noticed. I just didn't think it would make a difference. Thank you, though. Okay, I. Have to finish transferring the rest of the crap over. And it's super slow because I'm doing this on a tiny instance. I can try opening it locally. Hope there's no O days in here. So not being read properly or parsed properly. Again, the only thing I know how to do is check magic numbers. MP4. List of file signatures. Fuck. MPEG-4. So, the fact that it isn't recognized by file implies that another corrupted header, so I might have to build my own. FTYP, I think that's one of the command things. MP4 FTYP. Yeah, so there's a bunch of weird 4-digit commands, and this is one of them. So maybe the header's just missing. I don't know. Oh, I header. So I header, I think, is a PNG. What's the size of this thing? I don't even know. View details. So, could be possible that it's actually just one frame, stored as a PNG, and there's no deltas for other frames. I'm not sure. Okay, let's see what FTPY or FTYP means. Oh, that just means that is one F type or something. Okay, so MSNV. Okay, MPEG-4 for Sony PS4, I header. That's a PNG anyway. Okay. Okay, let's take a look at the PNG that we had. Okay. There's a PNG in here somewhere. This is kind of bullshit, but I'm gonna try to replace the header here, and then file save as otter.png. I'd be pretty impressed if this opened. Fuck. Is this correct? 8-9 M0 blah blah blah. I'm sure the header is longer than that. So I'm just making bullshit guesses about how many bytes later. So this is, there's more space between the I header and the PNG in the other one. Instead of actually being smart and trying to parse this using something like 01 or 10, whatever that hex header is, I'm going to be stupid. Is there a way to? Ooh. No. Is there a way to insert? Okay. Nope. Okay, I am gonna move on because that's my tactic for low levels like this. This is steg. I hate steganography, so that probably won't be fun to me. Let's see.
Message to deliver. Breaking news, a special advertisement, emergency information, or
let's just check the scoreboard. Okay, still. This is me trying to literally zoom in to see if there's anything. No, and that's it. I'm out of ideas. Oh, I forgot to run strings on it. That's why I didn't SCP it yet. That's why I don't like Windows, even if I SSH, just because things like using the scroll wheel just makes things go crazy. I'm not sure what the comment. How comments fit in JPEG. Com. So let's check the com field. This is almost readable. I think I'm kind of grasping at straws, but that's rot 13. Just a quick check, it doesn't do shit. Here's another really good tactic for getting flags. Sweet, that way I don't have to enter my password every time. I'll share that. Bastard. Tried that one, 100. I do that all the time. Okay, same idea. Look for magic numbers. That'd be hilarious if this is backwards. Okay. List. Control F. GIF. GIF 87A. GIF 89A. 87 or 89A. So this file is backwards. Let's write some Python. I honestly, what is it? D, easy way to reverse something. Okay, just oh, I should name it. Maybe it'll work. No, okay. Another one. This is 100. Yep. I do not think it does. That one is probably a little bit easier than 100 points deserves. And let's close the ones we don't care about. Okay. Flag. A bad habit I have is that instead of using real-world skills where I go, oh, you know, what kind of vulnerabilities might exist, I try to use riddles and hints. Like, I look at a binary and I go, like, there must be a vulnerability. So as soon as I find a bug, I think, this must be exploitable. But unfortunately, that has absolutely zero application to the real world. So I'm going to try not to read too much into this file name. I end. What's this? Okay. So I don't know what to do here, but it kind of makes me want to look at this one again that I fucked up. Because here I have a valid header, right? So if I can copy this, and where's this otter? Let's look at otter. So going back here, this is at byte B. This is also a byte B. So let's literally just type this over top. So 8950 4E 470D0A1A0. Oops, 0A 0000 000D. And then percent bang xxd dash r. Okay. Bam. Is it? Oh, I can increase the font size. Is it hard to read? What I did was I lowered the frame rate, hoping I could keep the resolution up. I wish I could see, remember which challenges I've actually solved. I haven't solved 10. Okay, I obviously got this one, I forget how. Solve that one. Haven't solved that one, so 10 and 40. Did I solve this one? Yeah, I solved this one. So 10, 40, 90, 110, and 500. This one is probably going to be really shitty. But let's take a look. Interesting. Three hours, interesting. Okay, what's that Audacity? Do I have it installed? I do, decent. Oh no, I don't. Okay, better install it. So it's mono one channel, that's easy. Sometimes you'll see like random flat spots and it'll be like Morse code or something dumb in there. So I just had to take a peek. I literally don't know how to zoom. Oh shit. So so it looks like it's just frequency increasing over time, I think. I don't know, it's just a changing pattern. Okay, this part in particular looks cool. Is there a way? How do I? There you go. If I'm gonna see anything cool like that. Always. Just walking this thing is work for this tiny instance. Five megs, yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, I know shit all about audio. I'm intimidated by this. I'm gonna go back to something else. This one is also intimidating to me for some reason. Flag does it. Let's take a look at that one. Almost 40. Okay, now if I remember correctly, if I remember correctly, yeah, it's PK I want to look for. and we'll see if there's more than one in here. But I would think that Dee Dee would find this. That's not it. Can't find any more. God damn. So why does it fail? End of central directory signature not found. Either files not a zip file or it constitutes one disk of a multi-part archive. Good time to skim through this thing right now. I was watching one of his streams. I didn't really watch the whole thing, but he mentioned a zip presentation. All right. Yeah, something about it ending at the end. You begin parsing from this. It must be at the end of the file. And they were talking about the comments, so this might be cool. Almost a meg. Hopefully it won't choke us too much. So PK, right? Fuck, so I don't know about that. And this was PK34. PK34 files. PK34. I don't know what the subsequent ones 5-6 are. LFH, CDH, EOCD, BMB, BGR. What about, what if it's another broken header? So, CDH, the way he did this is really cool. He actually builds a zip from a an assembler file. He just has a whole bunch of directives to make sure that when it's assembled, all the offsets are correct, and he just uses DB to put the explicit bytes everywhere. Okay, what I'm going to do is make some bullshit. Okay, so there's a file name, but there's more than one PK. That's a weird thing. What I was hoping for was to find this kind of crap. So, and see if it was normally preceded by some value, or if CDH had a PK somewhere before, maybe, you know, let's say here it was missing. Let's try a different idea. Okay, so this is a header, but it looks like a repeating XOR key. Perhaps. So, I mean, these are FS all the way down, and the rest, how long of a key is that? C4, C6, C7, okay, that's changing. I found this thing recently called Cyber Chef. It seems pretty neat. Let's see if it can actually help me. And what key should we do? Let's start with FFAC. Okay, so this should be null. So obviously this is taking it as raw bytes. So let's do it like this. Okay, FFAC BFC4. Right, all null. All null. No, these aren't all null. Is there a way to view? It'd be nice to be able to view this hex. FFAC BFC4, FFAC BCC4. I mean, fuck. We can try it. Go on this side. Oh, the only shitty thing is that clearly the CDH that we found isn't encrypted. That's too much of a coincidence. But see these FFs all the way through? So I'm thinking, like, what if these FFs are just junk? I don't know what these normally look like, but the FFs are 3 bytes apart, right? The only other shitty thing is that, why does it start at this arbitrary offset? But I could write Python that just cut off this header, and then I think for the rest of the file, let me check. Okay, I'm gonna write it up just in case. So this is offset, was it 88E? Okay. We'll say ref equals now, what's a clean way to do this? What I want to do is ignore every fourth byte. I'm sure this is incorrect, but I have no other ideas. Okay. And appending a string like this is actually really bad and dumb in Python, because it basically needs to allocate a backing string every time. It's actually better to do it in an array and then join it, but I don't care. This will just crash when it doesn't work, but. Sure. So it starts. So we're going to throw away the first and then read three. Hopefully that'll do it. So this is super slow because it's doing a syscall for every single byte in the file. So it'll do 800,000 of them, at least. Plus a write at the end. So what I can do is Control Z, Jobs. This will make it nice and slower. Oh shit, it's reading nothing. So, I'm glad I checked. I might have to ditch this session. That's what I thought. Okay. Keyboard layout changed. It reads a zero, which it shouldn't, but this would end, and we don't want that to happen. So we have to explicitly check that it's not none. Okay, so what it's going to do is read a garbage byte, read three, and append it, and then write it out loud. I think this is fruitless. Is there a way to freeze this so I only see what's going on? Control S. Okay, so what was it doing? It was seeking to the end for some reason. And it is that an optimization? For some reason it's reading. Oh, that's FD3, reading nothing out. Okay. Okay, let's try a different tactic. That was much faster. So it is about 25% short, which makes sense. Okay, fuck. let's. Okay, so. Same basic issue. Let's see if there's still CDR in there. There is. Is that an incrementing key? I do that every time. Let me just make sure I'm still in first. Oh, I'm good. Pip. Running out of ideas here. BMB. I actually donated to Wikipedia. I do every year, and they don't get rid of the pop-up, and it makes me want to take the money back. Jesus. Let's see if this thing has anything to do with it. Is there a search? Cool. Don't know what that means. Fucking, how do you get rid of it? That's probably okay. We had one where we found a PNG in that MP4 file. So this could be another magic. BGR. So. I'm going to ditch these two for now. Let's see if we can parse a PNG on this this thing, CyberChef. Oops. Let's try something. Every time. What is it? So what I did there, which worked pretty well, is I used just a regex to find capital letters only with exactly four in a row. My goal being trying to find those weird commands like iheader. For example, iheader should be in there. Right, obviously, because it's right at the top of the file. IDAT, that's more normal crap. Okay, let's make it so that no, it doesn't matter if it. This is kind of stupid bullshit, but let's look if there's a like a stego tool, because I know there are. I just don't do them enough to know about them. Open Stego. I don't even know if it's 64-bit. Okay. Java. That is literally enough trying for me on that tool. If they wanted me to use it, they'd make it easier to install. Good old online. See if we can find one online. Perfect. See, this is probably bullshit. Yeah, well, it only inputs it in. This would be useless though. It would only expect its own particular format. Let's ask the crew. There you go. Thank you. Wow, that is, I have no idea how it took it out, but it did. I have to kind of, what was the value? 110? Now, which ones are remaining? So, what was Otter again? That was easy. Oh, what the fuck? Weird. I solved 75. Weird. Of course. This is one thing I fucking hate about Windows. It's like a big pain in the ass to find out what's holding a handle to this. And like half the time you just have to restart your computer to get something like this deleted. Okay, anyway, 500 is that big ass sound thing. I don't feel like that. What was this? I don't think I feel like that either. This one's done. That one was difficult. Okay, I gotta do this one. This is embarrassing. I don't even have HXD open, do I? Did I get the comment? Or, well, I didn't solve that. If it was just a comment without a flag format? Right, I mean, I can try that. No, that didn't work. That's when I tried rot 13ing. I even tried rot 26. Let's try zstag. Oh, it's for PNG only, I guess. Yeah, I closed it, this, so I don't know why. Fuck. Fuck. Okay. All right. Let's try. Wow. I don't know why I didn't think of that. $400. Thank you very much for that. So This thing is driving me crazy. Let's see. Brockmon. Let's take a look. I don't think I actually looked at it much, I forget. I even forget if it played. Oh, it was like that short
message
video.
To deliver breaking news, a special advertisement, emergency information.
Okay, time for good old hex. And strings. Poof. Okay, that's not good. And what is the file size here? 22 megabytes, holy shit. What was the format? CSEC something. Oh my god. That happens when you use a scroll wheel in PuTTY. That's fucked up. There you go. I can DD that out. And I think it actually doesn't matter if I just rip it until the end of the file, probably, because you can tack extra data at the end of a PNG, I think. So let's try. So the file is huge as shit. Okay, I'll see if I can just do that. So basically what I do, input file is stegged, output file equals blah.png, has to be named blah, skip equals this offset. Oops. Oh yeah, that never works for me. Right, you have to do block size 1, which sucks, unless it's like a nice even number. And then for the count, I do this, which will do math for me. 229299906 minus 299866. And it's slow because it's doing another syscall for each byte. If you were smarter than I am, you would find the biggest factor of this number and create the block size that big. That way it can do fewer syscalls. Shit. Weird. Huh, cool. What's the value here? 90. in. Boom. So just two left. 40, the flag one. Let me try the bin walking. Now I know the bin walk didn't work. The weird thing is it doesn't even detect the zip. Wow, this machine is not set up for owning things. I can unzip it, not zip. My hope is that I could use tar to zip it, because tar can do GZ and BZ, but I guess it can't do normal zip. Okay, give me a minute, I'm gonna grab a drink. So that was kind of a guess. I really don't know what's going on here. Oh, see, the HXD definitely didn't cause that 75 point thing. This is bullshit. Oh shit. Yo, I got exactly twice as many points. No, I don't want to save. So apparently, apparently less can peek into the table of contents, but that's what dash L does. So clearly that's not going to help. Okay, end of central directory signature not found. Let's just see what Google says about this. Fuck! shit. I gotta have another machine somewhere. Oh, I forgot my login for this guy. This is my buddy's user, but he didn't change his password yet. Tar, cool, jar. Oh, he's not on the to-doers list. Fuck. Okay, so that won't work. I'm gonna switch to my Mac very quickly. One second. So much for online privacy. My like subtle attempt to not show you every file I have on my computer. Oh, and I can't even do my history because I'm incognito. Here I tried something. Jar. Sleep. Oh no. Come on. I don't know if, like, I don't shit all about what the stuff looks like compressed. The only thing that I see is this F bullshit and how this seems to be following some sort of pattern. A, C, E, B, F, B, E. Even down here, let's check. Oh, this seems higher entropy. On a different screen and see if I can find another zip file on my computer. Try to look at it. So this is just another zip file. I want to see what it looks like. Oh, I can't split or tear. Okay, so there's no like obvious like FF pattern. So I think that's why I couldn't close the directory. It was okay. That was me just trying to see if there's a. I tried before was using these four bytes as a repeating XOR key, but that would make every byte in these columns zero, and then these ones would be like low numbers probably, which doesn't look anything like real zip apparently. Holy shit. So I'm gonna look more into this. that list of magic numbers? Yeah, I didn't. I wish I had that 010. Let me try to see if I can get a demo of it. Okay, I haven't used this in a long time. Version flags. Yeah, I don't know how to know what to do here. So it's part of the file name? I don't know what I'm looking at here. I'm probably gonna move on from this one. What do I have left now? Oh, just two? Shit. It drives me absolutely crazy how that happens. Sound magic. IFF even sampled. That's all it comes with? Okay, let's see if I'm on my other window, but I'm basically I'm on my other window, but I'm basically going to see if there's any templates available for this type. I guess I should just do it here. No, they don't have it. Okay, well, shit. Let's see what they know here. IFF Falcon Data Format. I'm gonna switch back to HXD, only because I know how to use it. Okay. This will probably kill my AWS, but no, they wouldn't make it that easy. Okay. Unfortunately, it's time for me to cook dinner. I gotta sous vide some steak, so I think I've got to go. It's really hard. Yeah, I don't have. I'm gonna have to go anyway. So, how about I take a look later? But it was very fun, so thanks a lot for setting this up, man. And, 1 second. I want to still be in first. Okay. Hopefully I can stay in first for a bit longer. Alright, anyways, thanks everyone for watching. Cheers.